I just found out. That's why I'm doing this today, is Jimmy just came back. He was the last person to come back.
Well, let me play devil's advocate there for a second, because had you come out and set the record straight earlier, Gunner and Jack might not have been pulled off that plane, and Jimmy might not have had his passport impounded. So if you'd come forward and done an interview like this and told the real story earlier, couldn't you have taken away a lot of their problems?
Oh, by all means. And I think this is why I'm taking full responsibility for my actions, because if I didn't over-exaggerate the story to what I said when I did it, when it first happened with Billy Bush and yourself, and I told you the full story, none of this would have happened. We wouldn't be here. We wouldn't be sitting here discussing this.
So when you talked to Billy on Sunday afternoon, you didn't tell him the whole truth. When you spoke with me on Wednesday night by phone, you didn't tell me the whole truth.
I left details out, and which that's why I'm in this mess, is I left certain things out and I over-exaggerated some parts of the story.
One of the things you appear to have embellished with Billy when you talked to Billy is you said at some point after you refused to sit down, the security guard put the gun to your forehead and cocked it. That didn't happen?
That didn't happen, and that's why I over-exaggerated that part.
Why'd you do that?
I don't know why. You know, it was still hours after the incident happened. I was still intoxicated. I was still under that influence. And I'm not making me being intoxicated like an excuse. I'm not.
It is. It is an excuse. I knew you were going to say it. Oh.
I shouldn't have said that. I shouldn't even just kept it. Like, I'm not saying anything. But I over-exaggerated that part.
No, we're exaggerated. You lied.
Drawn, but not at my forehead. It wasn't cocked at my forehead. It was towards my general direction.
This damn
as you can see in the surveillance, that's where my hands went up.
You told me on the phone line, you said, we are victims here. We are victims, and we're happy that we're safe. In the police press conference, they said, not victims, they're vandals. How do you feel about that?
It's how you wanna make it look like. Whether you call it a robbery, whether you call it extortion, or us paying just for the damages. Like, we don't know. All we know is that there was a gun pointed in our direction and we were demanded to give money.
Well, and that's a really interesting point. I want to take a little time on this. If I were to ask you the same question again right now and say, were you robbed on Sunday morning in Rio? How would you answer it?
I'd be like, I can't answer that because I don't know.
Because you're a liar.
I was intoxicated, so I don't know. All I know is that there was a gun.
Oh, everything is.
We were demanded to give money. Whether it was to pay for the damages of the poster, whether it was extortion or whether
you
it was
were drunk.
Robbery. Like, I'm not equipped to.
Except
like,
I want to point out that Gunner, in his statement to police, said at some point someone who spoke English walked over and offered to help translate this altercation. And he made it clear that the security guard was telling the four of you, you need to pay for that stuff, that damage, before you can leave here, or I'm going to call the police. You understood that at that time, didn't you?
Yeah, so then we had to give the money.
Right, so but at that point, it's not a robbery.
But you got robbed.
You're striking a deal. You're striking a deal to pay for what damage you've caused so that he doesn't call the police. And this doesn't become a bigger incident. Isn't that fair?
We just wanted to get out of there.
Dude!
We were held. I mean, there was a gun pointed in our direction. We were all frightened.
Because y'all were drunk and messed up. Y'all messed up.
You have to give them money. So we gave money and we got out.
That doesn't sound like a robbery. A robbery is when some guy targets you, whether he's armed or not, to take your money and your belongings and your valuables. This guy was negotiating a deal because of what had happened in that walkway. And you guys were on the other end of that negotiation.
And that's why it could be, people can see it in many different directions. All we know is that
many directions.
And we were demanded to give them money.
You are locked in right now.
What I'm trying to get at is the first version of the story you told, Ryan, was much more about the mean streets of Rio.
Yeah.
And the version we're hearing now is much more about a negotiated settlement to cover up some dumb behavior.
And that's why I'm taking full responsibility for it.
Really?
Is because I over-exaggerated.
That's not what you did before.
I never did done that. We wouldn't be in this mess. Those guys would never be in Rio, or were in Rio. None of this would have happened, and it was my immature behavior of, you know, we just finished. We were wanting to celebrate, and we haven't been drinking or anything like months before that, and I definitely had
celebrate,
too much to drink.
Drink,
and I was very intense,
party.
And none of this would have happened.
And not lie afterwards.
Ryan Lochte talking to Matt Lauer earlier today, and we'll have more from their conversation coming up right after this break.
Just don't do it, dude. Drink, have your thing, and party. Don't lie afterwards.